So today's car is already full of digital experiences. As we know, if you rent a new car, if you buy a new car, it is full of digital experience. So digitalization is not a new thing for a car. But most of those digital experiences are individuals. Like if you see the kind of speedometer, if you see the kind of music player, all are like islands of their own. And the best example is if you are kind of taking 7 ice hockey players, junior age of 10, to your cars. They live in their YouTube, they live in their Spotify, so there are 7 islands of digital. And think about that network traffic that your car is actually sending to the network if there are 3 YouTubes or 7 YouTubes ongoing. So what we will see in the near future is that there will be more and more integrated experiences, and this kind of the one digital experience to the other one will be connected. And basically, the kind of, if we look at what is happening tomorrow, so the biggest change we see is of course the kind of this kind of all those experiences you have in the cloud come to your car. The kind of you will have more personalized services, and at the same time you will start sharing your car with your neighbor, with your friends, and it will kind of require that the software is able to adjust on your needs. So we start to see more and more personalization of those experiences. And then of course the third big change is the new phenomenons, kind of drones or electric cars, or the means of the transportation will change. So in the middle of all of these changes is of course connectivity. All of these experiences we see in the future will be connected. In mobile industry, this type of changes took in 15 years. It took 15 years to change from this kind of hardware focused, where the kind of software was just a glue on top of it, to cloud-based, what we have today, mobile phones. It took 15 years. In auto industry, this needs to happen in 5 to 10 years. So that the changes we have been experiencing, kind of, I guess most of us have been working, or at least using the mobile devices during the last 15 years. We saw that drastic change. But the kind of the ride that we will now go will be even harder. And there are good examples. The kind of McKinsey and Company made a study about the kind of how big these changes are. And what they learned was, for example, in this personalization and the car sharing, at the moment the kind of there is $32 billion is invested in kind of studying and looking for these opportunities in the connected and shared car economy. So the changes are massive, and the kind of what does it mean for the software? Of course, if you think about personalization, when you go to your car, it needs to recognize you. It needs to be able to kind of make the authentication. It needs to be able to adapt the car environment as it is for you. You don't want to have the same kind of look and feel as your neighbor, or the kind of your colleague. So the level of personalization will increase. But it's not only the look and feel, but it's also the kind of the insurance, for example. You don't want to pay your partner's insurance or your colleague's insurance. If that guy has kind of an accident every second month and has very high insurance payments, you don't want to have it. But of course the car needs to be able to understand that, hey, it is now this guy, this has very low profile of accidents, the kind of these kilometers are now kind of with the less cost. So the kind of all of these will have huge impact on the way the software needs to be built, because the amount will increase and the complexity will increase under the hood. But for the user, it cannot increase. Today's cars are almost impossible to handle. So the kind of we need to lift up the performance of the whole industry. And the most importantly, all of the experiences will be connected to internet. So there is not going to be any standalone experience in the car. If we look at now the kind of how this evolution of internet and the dialogue, how you had it kind of has evolved during the kind of recent couple of the tens of years, all the services are there. They have been and they will be. So the question is, how do you have the dialogue? How do you kind of exchange information with the internet? In the desktop world, it was easy. You had a kind of a screen that was stable, you had a keyboard, you had a mouse. So then, and then the rich experience were very easy to do, to kind of the experience. What happened when people tried to make that mobile? Who remembers WAP, WAP? So only one fifth, so a very small group of people. Actually, I'm surprised. So the first dialogue, the mobile dialogue with the internet was very clumsy. It was text-based, very boring to use. Nobody started to use it. Second generation, the people of Nokia's and Ericsson's tried to bring the whole internet to your mobile phone. Again, a disaster. Didn't work. It took kind of 15 years before Apple came with apps. Hey, they simplified the internet dialogue. So now it was very easy for consumer to have the dialogue with internet because it was easy to use apps. So the full richness of internet was not brought into the kind of consumer's use. What we will see now happening at the moment is again a next phase of this dialogue with internet. It is kind of through this kind of digital assistants. So digital assistants are simplifying the internet richness to us, and at the same time, the kind of artificial intelligence is simplifying the world to internet. So there's a lot of simplification taking now place, and therefore, kind of our guess is that kind of we will see a lot of these digital assistants in the car. Because you need to focus on the road, you need to focus what you are doing, but at the same time you can speak, you can listen. So there will be a much richer interaction with internet than ever before. So it will be even richer than it was in the desktop industry. And the kind of, we believe the kind of the that is kind of shared with most of the industry kind of the thought leaders. Like Dieter May from BMW said that we should not create digital island of its own into the car. We should bring whatever consumers have outside the car into the car. And that is something we need to all remember when we think about this experience, that if you bring something that is totally isolated into the car, it may fail in the same way as WAP kind of they failed in the early 2000s. When you take all of this into the cloud, magic happens. You will get a mobile experience. So it's not anymore so that kind of your experience is in mobile phone or home or car, but actually what happens is that the same experience follows you from different contexts to the other one. Spotify is pretty close on this already today. So if you have Spotify account, premium account, you go to your home, you listen to Spotify. The kind of you open your mobile phone, you press the play, the same song continues. You go to your car, you connect to the Bluetooth, the same song continues. So we start to see these kind of pioneers of the industry taking this mobility to the next level. And we believe at Qt that the kind of all the experience will be mobile. And what does it mean for us as a company? Of course, why we are talking about this? If you think about the kind of when Qt was founded, it was about the mobility. It was the app mobility over different platforms. Now we are talking about the experience mobility across the different contexts. So this is very natural continuation for Qt as a technology. Let's then jump to concrete what the auto industry is doing at the moment. It is bloody difficult to make digital experience into today's car. Therefore, there are cost overruns, there is feature drops. All of these phenomena, what happens when somebody who is very good in making hardware is moving to software industry. We saw this in mobile, we see it now in automobile, and there are new industries that will face exactly the same problem, the kind of the when software becomes suddenly the most important thing, whereas it was just a glue kind of earlier. Luckily, there are technologies like Qt. So basically, if you go to road today, there are very many different implementation of Qt. So depending on the ambition level of the tier one, depending on the ambition level of OEM, how our technology is used. So some of our partners are just using some of the core components, whereas the kind of the other end of our partners are looking at the Qt as a platform. So they are encouraging their suppliers, their third-party developers to use Qt so that it's very easy to implement the holistic car experience. Why people take different approaches? Of course, it is the understanding how far they are in a kind of in the understanding how important the software is, how good people they have in, what is their relationship with tier ones. So there are a lot of now different reasons why people have selected a kind of different strategy with Qt. But the most important thing is that you can see Qt already on the road. And the kind of the, there is very many car programs at the moment that are kind of the implementing and kind of future experience with Qt. What is our vision kind of for the future? We think the car will be a single computing unit or single computer. So basically, there is one hardware kind of you that is running all the screens in the car. You may have different needs for cluster, backseat, and the kind of the IVI. But kind of the it is single computer that is kind of taking care of that. And why Qt is good in this kind of environment is because you can run actually and you can create the experience that goes from IVI to cluster, even to HUD, and all the icons, all the experience, how it has been implemented, look and feel the same. You cannot see when you enter into the car which technology has been used, and the differences between the technologies. And then a very important point here is that we believe, as I already mentioned a couple of times, that the experience will be cloud-based. There will be this kind of horizontal players who will implement the kind of certain music experiences, video experiences, and then there's OEM who wants to add their flavor. So the Spotify in Mercedes should feel a little bit different than Spotify in Toyota or in the Mazda. So we believe that there is this kind of combination of scale that comes from the third parties that are global player and the flavor of the kind of OEM, how they want to feel, what is their brand, how they want that experience to feel. And the kind of, and of course we at Qt Company, we are now building the capabilities for this. And therefore what we promise to kind of the tier one software developers or the kind of the OEMs is basically three things. So we want to kind of create a technology kind of for unified digital cockpit. So you don't need to anymore decide kind of, okay, I need this technology for this screen, this technology for this screen, but actually you can make a choice that, hey, it's one technology, I can use all the screens. We want to make the tool chain so efficient that kind of this kind of iterative development is possible. So designer makes a design in the morning, next morning or evening, he or she can see that in real environment. Because that is the only way to get this experience on the level where the mobile device is at the moment. Because if you have this kind of a months long cycle where you have the CRs and negotiations, hey, how this look on paper, and hey, in Adobe it looked like this, and now it looks in my target environment like this, we cannot get rid of those problems we have. But if we are able to make this reiterative process fast enough, the kind of we can create great experience. And the third but not last thing is the ecosystem. The kind of what we want to enable is that each OEM, each tier one, can create their ecosystem in a way the kind of that if they engage with the global brick brands or small local companies in creating the experience, you can still have the look and feel of the brand in the car. And the kind of that is possible if you have a single unified developer experience and the kind of single environment where everybody is developing. And the kind of now we are investing at Qt Company making that possible, so that kind of we call it kind of OEM SDK or whatever name we use it, but in a way basically that the kind of OEM is delivering that to their ecosystem. Hey, now we have upgraded the Qt version, or we have upgraded this hardware version, etc. Here are the drivers. Everybody can start work from the next morning with the same new environment. And as already said, in the core is the SDK. And I already went a little bit through, but basically what happens, sorry, now I need to walk up. So what happens here is that the kind of open tier one creates their standing style. How they want to feel the icon, how they want to feel the colors, etc. They implement the kind of the SDK. Then they put their own stuff into it and delivers that to their own developer teams, to tier one developer teams, and even to the third parties. And what they will get back is that everything looks like done by one team. So the idea of the SDK is that everything looks same as done by one team, although it has been 1,000 engineers from 50 different companies working on that one. And to summarize, what we offer at Qt Company is the kind of, we want to have a multi-screen digital experience, so all the tooling, all the investments we are now doing, and you can see the demo areas, we have safe renderers, we have the 3D tooling, so we are building now the capabilities that kind of all the screens can be done with Qt. We are investing heavily on the tool chain so that kind of you can create this reiterative kind of process. And then we are looking now the kind of the capabilities to build the SDK so that you can select whatever hardware, whatever software, and then you can create your own SDK and be efficient kind of around that. And during these 2 days, you will hear more about the details and the kind of the actual technologies, how we are implementing what I have been talking here. I just wanted to use this opportunity, first of all, to thank you coming here, then a little bit give the direction that we are investing, what we are doing, and the context for the rest of the 2 days. Thank you. If any questions.